Good morning, students. Let's solve today practice 8.4 question number 7. If 14 buses can seat 602 people, how many people could be seated in two such buses? Okay. Now what is given? 14 buses. In 14 buses, how many people? 602 people. Okay. In 14 buses. 602 people. And what it is asked? How many people could be seated in two such buses? So what we have to find in two buses? How many people can seat? Okay. So now it is given for 14 buses. 14 buses, 602 people can seat. Okay. Then in two buses, how many people can seat? So first we should know in one bus how many people can seat. That we should know first. See, it is asked to find two buses, how many people can sit. But we should know in one bus how many people can sit. Then we can find for two buses. Okay. So, see here I will write. In one bus, how much? How many people are there in one bus? Okay. See here I have given question mark. 14 buses, 602 people can sit. Then in one bus, how many people can sit? Then we can find for two. Okay, if we get the answer for one bus, how many people can sit? Then we can find in two buses, how many people can sit? Okay, so first we should know for one. Okay, so now let's find in one bus, how many people can sit? So, people can sit in one bus. What we have to find? We have to find in one bus how many people can sit. Okay. People can sit in one bus. That we have to find how many people can sit in one bus. It is given for 14 and it is asked for 1. Okay. Given for 14 and we have to find for 1. It is asked for 2. But we have to find for 1. Then only we can find for 2. So it is given for 14 bus. 14 buses, 602 people. Now we have to find for in one bus how many people can sit. Okay, so it is given for many and we have to find for one. So we have to divide. Given for many and we have to find for one bus. Okay, see, given for 14 bus and we have to find for one bus. So we have to divide. So for 602 we will divide by 14. Okay, for 602 we will divide by 14. So see here I will show you the calculation in graph. 602. 14 4s are 56. 0 minus 6 is not possible. So take borrow. Here will remain 5. 10 minus 6, 4. 5 minus 5, 0. Now what we got here? 42. 14 3s are 42. 14 3s are 42. So what we got as 602 divided by 14. What we got? 43. So people can sit in one bus. How many people can sit in one bus? 43 people. Okay. Okay. 43 people can sit in one bus. So what we write here? 43 people can sit in one bus. Okay. Now we got in one bus 43 people can sit. Okay. So see here I am writing in one bus how many people can sit? 43. See, 43 people can sit in one bus. We got people can sit in one bus 43. Okay. So in one bus 43 people. And what it is asked in the question? In two such buses, how many people could be seated in two such buses? So we have to find in two buses how many people can sit. Yes, in one bus, we got in one bus how many people can sit? 43. And it is asked to find in two buses how many people can sit. Okay, now we have got for one and we have to find for many. Means for two. So we need to multiply. Okay, so in two buses, people would be seated in two buses. could be seated in two buses. People could be seated in two buses. We have to find for two buses. This now we have got for one bus and we have to find for two. So what we are going to do? We are going to multiply. Okay. So for 43 people, we multiply by 2. So 2 3s are 6, 2 4s are 8, 86. Okay. So 86 people. Okay. So what we will write at last? How many people could be seated in two such buses? 86 people could be seated in two such buses. Okay. 86 people could be seated in two such buses. Okay. So what we got answer? 86 people could be seated in two such buses. Let's solve question number 9. Sehwag made 48 runs in 6 overs and Sachin made 98 runs in 14 overs.
Divide.
So we have to find for 1 over how much run? So for 98 we will divide by 14. For 98 runs we will divide by 14. So we will get the number of runs. So 98 divided by 14. 14 sevens are 98. See, 14 ones are 14. 14 sevens are 98. So 7 runs. Okay. So in 1 over. 1 over means only per over. Okay. So per over. Okay. So what we will write? Sachin made 7 runs per over. Okay. 7 made 8 runs per over and Sachin made 7 runs per over. So who made more runs per over? Who made, compare it now. See, he has also made in per over. 7 made per over 8 runs and Sachin made per over 7 runs. Then who made more runs in per over? 7 made more runs in per over. Okay. Who made more runs per over? 7 made more runs per over. Let's solve question number 10. If 33 workers can dig 165 holes in an hour. Okay. 33 workers can dig 165 holes in an hour. How many holes could 27 workers can dig in an hour? Okay. So what is given, that we will write in short. 33 workers. How many holes? 165 holes. Okay. 33 workers can dig 165 holes in an hour. Okay. Then how many holes could be 27 workers? When 27 workers can dig in an hour, how many holes? Okay. So we have to find the number of holes can dig by 27 workers in an hour. Okay. 33 workers, 165 holes. And it is asked to find 27 workers, how many number of holes? Okay. So first we should know for one worker can dig how many holes. Okay. So to get 27 workers can dig how many holes? So for that first we should know one worker can dig how many holes. Okay. So first we will find for 1. Then we will find for 27. So 33 workers, 165 holes. Then one worker can dig how many holes? Okay. How many holes? See, number of holes. I have given here question mark. How many number of holes? Okay. So now it is given for many and we have to find for one worker. Given for 33 workers. Given for 33 workers and it has, we have to find for one worker. So we need to divide. Okay. So one worker can dig. One worker can dig how many number of holes, that we have to find. So for 165 holes, we will divide by 33. Okay. Yes, we have to find for one worker can dig how many holes, na? One worker can dig holes. Okay, one worker can dig how many number of holes? So one worker can dig. So for 165 holes, we will divide by 33. Okay. So 165 divided by 33. See here, 165 divided by 33. Now see, these both the numbers are divisible by 3. Okay. 3 ones are 3, 3 ones are 3. 3 fives are 15, 3 fives are 15. See, for 165 you can divide by 3. So you will get 55. So 55 upon 11. 11 ones are 11, 11 fives are 55. So what we got? 5 upon 1. 5 upon 1 means only 5. So one worker can dig 5 holes. Okay. So one worker by bones. Okay, so what we got? One worker can dig 5 holes in an hour. Okay, so right here, one worker can dig 5 holes in an hour. Okay, in 1 hour, see, one worker can dig 5 holes in an hour. Now we got one worker. Okay, one worker can dig 5 holes. How many holes? 5 holes. Okay, then what it is asked? How many holes could be 27 workers can dig? Then 27 workers can dig how many number of holes? Okay, so how many holes? How many holes? We have to find the number of holes. How many holes could 27 workers can dig in an hour? Okay, so one worker can dig 5 holes in an hour. Then 27 workers we have to find. Now it is, we have got for one and we have to find for many. Means if it is given for one and asking for many, then we need to multiply. Now see, we got for one worker. See, one worker can dig 5 holes. Then we have to find for many workers. So we need to multiply. Okay, so 27 workers is equal. 27 workers can dig how many number of holes? So 27 into 5. Okay, so 5 7s are 35, 3 is carry, 5 2s are 10, and 3 30. So 135 holes. Okay, 135 holes. So what we will write at the end? How many holes could 27 workers can dig? So 27 workers can dig 135 holes in an hour. Okay, so 27 workers can dig 135 holes in an hour.